Nobody knew what they were doing, but everybody was really enthusiastic. It's like, how are we going to do this? I don't know, but let's figure it out.
What can you learn about human nature from animation? That is what Eric Darnell wants to know. Eric is one of the pioneers of computer-generated movies. He was the director of blockbuster animations like ANTZ, the Madagascar movies, Penguins. He's now decided that the future of filmmaking is this. He's passed up the big bucks of Hollywood to run his very own VR studio startup called Baobab, and he's realised that in order to make the ultimate virtual reality film, you need to understand people.
You know, in my career after 20 years of, you know, doing 5 feature films, I started to feel like I was repeating myself a little bit, even though I'm proud of everything I did. And this has just been a whole new thing. Yeah, so Penguins came out in fall of 2015, and I was sort of wondering what my next project would be. And then I met my partner, Marine Fan, and she had a VR headset. She said, you gotta try this on. The immersion that you feel when you put these headsets on, the fact that you really feel like you're somewhere. And for a storyteller, to be able to take the audience out of that theater seat where all you can do is look through a rectangle at a world that you can never be a part of with characters that have no idea that you exist, take them out of that seat and put them through that rectangle into that world and have a character turn and look at you and go, oh, hi, welcome to my world. And you feel like you're actually there. VR reminded me of the beginning days of computer animation when nobody knew what they were doing. Everybody's excited about it. Nobody knows where it's going. It's like, how are we going to do this? I don't know, but let's figure it out. And the sky's really the limit. And then I think what's most exciting to me are the things that we can't do in any other medium.
Like right what?
Now. Well, like the holodeck.
End programming.
Yeah. You know, Star Trek.
Yes.
It's not happening today.
I love that you could intuit I was a Star Trek nerd. I appreciate that, that I give off that pheromone, that very particular pheromone.
Exactly. Do you see something?
Yeah, it's very cold.
Is it snowing?
Yes. You know, you really can't go wrong with an adorable bunny rabbit.
And you hear Ethan Hawke?
Yep. To be fair though, I always hear the voice of Ethan Hawke. It's just one of my deep problems. Oh, spaceship, hi. I just realized that if I walk, it doesn't do anything. This is the level of intellect that you're working with.
For me, one of the biggest mistakes that people make is to move the viewer's point of view without the viewer actually physically moving. It's a recipe for nausea.
Yeah, it is.
Because your eyes say, I'm accelerating, and your inner ear says, I'm sitting in a chair doing nothing.
Yeah.
And your brain says, uh-oh, disconnect. And in the 99.999% of our human evolution, when the brain says, uh-oh, disconnect, that means that you ate something poisonous. And so your brain says, I better do something to get this poison out of my body. I better make my body sick. And everybody has a different level of reactivity to that kind of thing. They did a study where they put people on roller coasters and, you know, flight simulators and just the worst possible experience.
I hope they paid those people well.
Well, they timed how long it took before they ripped off the headset and went, no, God, get me out of here. And then they tested their depth perception. And they found that the better the person's depth perception was, the more likely they were gonna get sick sooner. So the people with really bad depth perception could like hang in there for a long time.
Right.
So whenever you hear some guy, you know, going, hey, I can take it, you know, I don't get sick in VR. It's like, well, how's your eyesight?
Yeah,
so
right.
You can wear that as a badge of honor while you're throwing up in the toilet. I've got really good eyesight.
Here's a bucket.
He's bouncing towards me.
Whoa.
Invades your personal space.
Yeah. No, that's, Jesus. Either I'm very small or that is a giant bunny rabbit.
Yeah, you're a bunny too, actually.
Good to know.
Doing things to inspire the audience with their free choice to look wherever they want, to find the things that we wanted them to find was really important. And you do that with sound, you do it with the character that's on screen suddenly looking off screen and inspiring you to look that way. And the viewer becomes an accomplice.
Yeah.
They become like Sam to Frodo. So Frodo is driving the story forward, right?
Yeah.
But without Sam, Frodo never would have got to Mordor. You don't want to like have the audience go, whoa, I want to watch the clouds right in the middle of the joke, right before the punchline.
And you've so really got to be an expert in the psychology of it, don't you?
There's a lot of psychology involved. In fact, it's remarkable how powerful simple things like if the audience cocks their head, 2 seconds later you have the character cock their head, and while the audience may not recognize that there's this mimicry going on, that's the kind of thing we do in real life when we're communicating with one another that says, hey, I like you, or I'm interested in you, or tell me more. So it's really incredibly important if we're trying to develop relationships between the viewer and these artificial fake characters that we're creating. What matters really is what's inside the character. And that's where the real heart and soul is. And that's what an animator's job is really all about. It's not about a walk cycle, you know, or you know, hands on hips, staring up at the sky.
But it helps.
It helps, it can't hurt. You know, I always loved animation. So for me, what's really matters is the animator can let the audience know through the body language of the character they're animating, what's going on inside that character's head. That's what's really exciting and invigorating for me about getting involved in it now. And it's something you can't describe to people. You have to put a headset on to really know. It's also just exciting and vibrant, and there's so much to discover and so much that we don't know that it's really a blast.
Eric, it's an absolute pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much.
It was great. Thank you.